We want to determine the equation of the blue square root function based upon how it's been transformed from the basic square root function graphed here in red. The first thing we should recognize about the blue square root function is that it's been reflected across the x-axis. Next, to determine how it's been translated, it'll be helpful to analyze corresponding points on the basic square root function and our blue square root function. So for example, this point here has the coordinates 0, comma 0, and this point here has coordinates 4, comma 2. So the corresponding points would be this point here with coordinates 1, 2, and then if we increase the x-coordinate by 4 units, as we did below, we'd be here at the point 5, 0. Notice how the difference in the y-coordinates here and the difference in the y-coordinates here is still 2, so there's not going to be a vertical stretch, but the blue function has been shifted right 1 unit. And up 2 units. So this should be enough information in order for us to determine the equation of the blue function. If we let f of x equal the basic square root function, and we let g of x be the function in blue, based upon our transformations, since the function has been reflected across the x-axis, we would have negative f of x, but because it's been shifted right 1 unit, we'd have f of the quantity x minus 1, and then because it's been shifted up 2 units, we would have plus 2. Again, the negative represents the reflection across the x-axis. The quantity x plus 1 represents the shift right 1 unit, and the plus 2 here represents a shift up 2 units, which means g of x would be equal to negative square root of the quantity x minus 1 plus 2. Now let's go ahead and verify this on our graphing calculator. So we'll press y equals, type in our function, negative, and then for the square root we press second x squared, the quantity x minus 1, close parenthesis, and then plus 2. And now let's make sure that our window matches the window here. So we'll press window. Notice the x min is negative 2, the x max is 11. Changes to 11. Y min here is negative 3, and the y max is positive 3. And now we can press graph, and notice how it does look like our function matches the given blue function. Let's also verify that it does contain these two points. So we'll press second graph. Notice how the point 1, 2 and the point 5, 0 are on our function. So this does verify we found the equation of our function correctly. I hope you found this helpful.